as we said, it's a constant flow of data. And there could be a situation where there are just a few records moving around in a specific point in time, or there might be other situation where the same exact application is facing a bigger load. And there are technical approaches that can help you, or architectural solution that can help you to prepare, to get ready, to not have those delays, or have delays that you can accept. So there is the idea of just scaling up your streaming application, which could be as simple as bringing up the number of replicas in your Kubernetes replica set, or having an auto-scaling solution. Or you could reach actually a limit for the underlying streaming solution, which could be Kafka that you're using, which even though you scale up the number of your replicas, it will not actually impact the lag, which is this delay that we're talking about. And in Kafka, for example, this concept is related to the partitions. So you have topic where you see data going through, and that topic is split in multiple partitions. And the partition, the number of partitions is the unit of parallelization in Kafka. So if you're consuming from one topic and that topic has four partitions, you cannot have five replicas reading from that topic. Or better, you can have five replicas reading from that topic. One of them will be idle. Four of them will consume data, each one from a different partition, and the fifth one will be waiting for actually getting access to one of the partition when one of the other four will go offline. So there are multiple places and multiple approaches to make sure that the lag is not a problem, but it's for sure something to take into account when you design a streaming solution.